The reason why Glee is in the cultural zeitgeist is not just because kids sing along and because it was a phenomenon in terms of success, but it led to things like this, you know, intellectual ninjas like Glenn Beck.
A year ago, I was watching the show Glee with my wife, and we watched it like this. I mean, it's horrifying, some of the things that they're teaching high schoolers. And I said to her at the end of this about a year, year and a half ago, we lose. There is no way to beat that. Well, yes, there is. We've spent about a year now trying to put together a pushback.
There you go. Glenn Beck set out to crush
Glenn. Good old Glenn.
That is an incredible part of the dialogue, though, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, well, you know, I think it's cool that that's even part of a dialogue, you know, something that is so culturally relevant that can reach a guy like Glenn Beck. I think that's really cool, for better or for worse.
Worse.
Depending on what side of the coin you're on. You know, it's being talked about.
Is it a challenge, though, to try to sometimes keep it about the discussion? Because there are lots of things, like there's much of life is a gray area, mm-hmm. granted, yeah, but yeah. There are things that are black and white. Mm-hmm. Human rights issues, they're black and white.
Yeah.
And you mean, there's pressures to be, yeah, it's a big network show mm-hmm. that reaches all of America. Have there ever been pressures on you guys not to be political?
Well, I think we've never really been political.
I think your presence alone is, to be honest with you. I think Glee on TV is political, just by being there.
Well, then cool. I mean, I don't think anyone's in the writer's room sort of twisting their mustache to see if they can, you know, reach any agenda.
We're gonna make high school kids gay.
Yeah, exactly.
Everybody's gay.
And on their list, they're like, let's piss off Glenn Beck.
Right.
I mean, that's just gonna happen. Like, you know, whether he wants or not.
LGBT event with President Obama.
Do you know how I got that? I'm sorry to veer this off. Pink was scheduled to sing for this, and she unfortunately got some kind of stomach flu or something, so she was in the hospital. And I was kind of flabbergasted because I was like, what kind of Rolodex do they have in the White House? So they're like, okay, Pink, what's next? Darren. Like, I don't see how that works. It's like, I could have called Barbara or, like, you know, Bette Midler, like someone, like, you know, pretty cool. I guess they must have lost a bunch of cards, you know.
Before we let you go, really quick, rapid fire. What did President Obama say to you when you talked to him?
Oh, I'll do exactly. Okay, so my whole plan with Obama was to fist bump him. So I need you to do, you'll be me.
Okay.
Okay, so you do, go, my man.
Okay, that's
me.
Okay,
so that
I
was
love
me.
It. All right.
And I'll be President Obama, okay. And I'll do exactly what he did. Right. Can we stand? Can we get out of frame?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, right.
Now pretend
right.
I'm much taller
so I'm
than you.
All right. All right.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah.
So he's sitting there.
Okay.
All right.
You're taller than you're Obama.
Yeah. Okay.
Right.
Cool.
I walk in. I'm just like, my man.
Oh, come on, man. You got a boom.
For real?
Yeah. He told me to boom. He corrected me on my fist bumping etiquette.
Look, come on, you got a boom.
Yeah, it was like, this is so presidential. Like, not only are you telling me what I'm doing wrong, but you're telling me how to do it better.
Jesus.
Bam.
I wanted to ask you next what you wish he would say to you, but I already know the answer. He did it.
That's the best story I have, yeah.